Guys Want Cars, but I'm back at you with another video. DQ here, Nikki Hands behind the camera. We finally have the lifted Subaru ready to go off-roading. What we're going to do today is take it out in the woods and show you what it can do. And then we'll get back on camera while we're doing some on-road driving and tell you how it does on the road. What's up, guys? We're out in the woods now, trailing around in the Subi. I just wanted to talk about, how awesome this car is now with the lift and with the tires. These Yokohama Geolander all-terrains are seriously impressive. Oh, yeah, we came through. This thing's a tank. somebody hiking.
We're out here. This is
where we came at. Yeah, this is... Tires are sick. These tires, you hit the gas. I mean, we're on some pretty solid icy snow. It's been freezing cold the last 3 days. And, like, we're on ice right now. You hit the gas, and the car still has grip. It's just, these tires are so impressive to me. It's not even funny.
It's crazy.
That's funny. The guy goes, there's a lot of water that way.
Yeah, he's looking out for us. We know. We've been through it.
Although coming this way is a little different.
This is different. You're going to break through. We're going to go through.
I'm going to creep
what we're talking about. Oh, yeah, we got through.
Oh, no. He broke.
Oh, he broke through.
Get the camera.
Let's show you.
Oh. They're in there. That's deep, bro. I think you're lucky that didn't break. Yeah, I think.
That guy just goes.
Hey, man.
He's like, there's a lot of water up ahead.
I was like, yo, we don't know how deep it is.
I'm gonna go ahead and say he got lucky that didn't break through on his car. Because that would have been bad.
Dude, that was the ultimate fucking adrenaline rush.
Yeah, that was amazing.
I said that to him before the puddle happened.
Yeah.
I was just looking for him online when that happened.
Look at the aftermath.
I know Michael.
Holy shit, dude.
Looking for a Cherokee.
Did that look fucking awesome?
That was amazing. You have to see it. That was amazing.
Up on flat ground.
I'm so glad I got to drive for that one.
That was awesome.
All right, so yeah. Now you guys see exactly where we are. We're out here.
Yeah, we're taking the Subis through some crazy, crazy terrain.
That's the kind of stuff we're doing today. So, to think that, you know, we're trailing behind a Jeep like that.
Climbing her, huh?
Wow.
Oh, boy.
I can't see now.
Hey, you're good. On the right? You're good.
Yeah. Oh.
Show you guys once again what we're doing. It's crazy stuff. So yeah, this is what the Subi can do off-road with these tires. And then, the question is though, can you still daily it? So we're gonna answer that a little bit later. But for now, we're having some fun, show you guys some cool trail shots.
He's making it look way harder than it is.
Oh my god. Oh my god. This is gonna be bad,
yeah,
dude.
Hold on.
Oh man.
Keep your feet up.
Jesus Christ.
Uh-oh, we didn't even take on water. Oh man, I made that shit look easy compared to his shit.
Dude, that was crazy.
met your match. So, oh man.
Oh yeah, this is sketchy. Holy shit.
Woo. Thank God diamond
in. You're going the wrong way.
Oh shit.
Oh man.
I thought it was gonna roll.
Yeah, that was really scary.
Guys, here we are in the Subi, driving down the highway. You just got to see a little bit of the off-roading and a nice little reveal and walk around. You know, real quick, if you didn't watch the video on the actual lift, the car, to get it where it's at, is 05 Forester struts, full set, brand new OEM, 05 Forester struts in my 98 Subaru Impreza. The tires, I went from a 195 60 15 to a 215 70 15 Yokohama Geolander all terrains. Phenomenal tires. These tires blow my mind with how well they grip. Off camera, the other day I was going up Mount Beacon and it was all icy, and just the traction I was getting in the car was really mind blowing, honestly. We'll see what happens in the spring when we get in some real mud and see what they do in some mud. But as far as snow and frozen snow, like you just watched in the video, that's all, you know, snow that had been on the ground already, and then we had really freezing temperatures. It's all hard, but it's not powder or anything like that. But the car just grips. On the road, you know, a big part of what I wanted to accomplish was being able to have a lifted, fun Subaru and still be able to daily it comfortably. And I think we've accomplished that. You know, I've been driving the car for 3 weeks now, and the alignment, after the alignment shop, spent a lot of time getting it straight. The alignment's great, the car drives pretty straight. You know, the suspension feels great. I mean, you definitely take away from the handling a little bit, but it doesn't really matter. You know, the stiffer suspension kind of compensates for that body roll that you would expect from your center of gravity being higher. But I mean, yeah, you know, you start throwing it through turns, you feel the body swaying back and forth, but it's not horrible.
It's still dailyable.
Yeah, it's totally dailyable.
You're not
totally
wanting to go 80 on the highway in this car anyway.
No. You know? But you still can.
Yeah, you still want to, yeah.
But no, it's just a really enjoyable car. I mean, you notice a little bit of it loses a little bit of the peppiness when you're on the throttle. It took me about a week to get used to it. It definitely felt different. The brakes definitely feel a little bit more sluggish. I mean, they were kind of sluggish to begin with. You know, you said it.
I don't like your brakes anyway.
They were a little bit sluggish to begin with, but with the bigger tires and everything, you definitely feel it. But it still stops. I mean, you know. But I do see, because I watched a video, some guy did a bigger brake set, and I do see why some people would want to do that. I think if you went bigger, with bigger wheels, heavier wheels, bigger tires than what I went with, then you probably would want to look into upgrading your brake system. But it's not necessary.
I don't see it, yeah. But yeah, I'm also going to drive this thing and get my thoughts, because I've yet to drive it.
Yes.
So I'm going to get into that now, and see what I'm thinking of it, and then wrap this bad boy up.
Yeah, buddy.
All right, so I'm driving the Subi now, and I'm gonna give my thoughts on it. Yeah, right off the bat, just my initial thoughts. It feels exactly the same as how it did before when I used to drive it rarely, but
mean, yeah, you just feel like you're sitting higher, like a lot higher. Like the difference in height and ride height is pretty significant when I'm behind the wheel. As a passenger, you feel it too, but behind the wheel, I feel like I'm actually in an SUV now. And you are height level, like window to window with most SUVs when you're in this. Yeah, I mean, initial thoughts. Yeah, it is a little more sluggish than it was to get up to a normal speed. I definitely noticed that.
You gotta drive with a heavier foot.
Yeah, which is no problem for me. takes bumps very nicely. Stiff, right? Nice and stiff. Come down there.
It feels a lot more rugged.
Yeah.
Right? Like you can already feel it in the suspension and the way it rides. Like you feel like you can handle a lot more now.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Cornering, I mean, it really doesn't feel much different to me. It really doesn't. Like, that's just my thoughts coming from someone out on the outside, you know? Yeah, dude, I love it. Like I said before, this is my favorite car that Dylan's owned after he did this to it. It's become my favorite car that he's owned. Just from the versatility aspect of it and just, like, how it really is the perfect daily. It can get you through virtually any climate, any type of weather. It's great on gas. I mean, it's like the best of both worlds smashed into one old-looking wagon, which is perfect.
Oh,
so.
Stop. Go take that trail.
Oh. Okay.
Wait, maybe. Yeah, fuck it.
What?
Take the trail.
Take it.
All right. I want you to get the full experience. The sign says no motorized vehicles, so we're just going to make sure nobody sees us.
All right.
You're just going to hammer down.
Sounds good to me.
Barrel right in. don't be afraid to get it.
Yeah, I just fucking flew into that because it's you know, as usual, we're not really supposed to be here.
Yeah, there's no fun places to off-road in New York that aren't illegal.
Yeah.
So if you want to, like, what I do is when I'm trailing, this is actually a good tip for other people that want to trail with a Subaru, slow down, banger down in the first. That you're creeping gear.
Yeah, I don't feel like I need to do much creeping. I mean, you know,
you can. You feel like you could go.
Yeah,
you could go.
I'm just. This is like a normal road for me. To give you an idea of what we're on, I mean, videos never do justice, but you know, this is like a moderate trail, very light for what we normally do with this car.
Yeah, very light compared to what we normally.
But I mean, there's some big bumps and big rocks and shit, some mud, and it's just chugging. You know, like this zero fucking issue. And yeah, some little mud ruts. Yeah, no problem whatsoever. I'm loving it, man. Like,
yeah,
no, I said,
the car handles everything beautifully.
This is great. Jesus.
But yeah, I mean, like, Nick's getting to experience, and, you know, anybody else that wants to off-road with their Subi a little bit, you know, you just, you got to be mindful that you are in a car and not a truck, right? Yeah, you are in a car, not a truck. It doesn't have skid plates yet. Maybe in the future it will, but, you know, so definitely be mindful of rocks and stuff. You don't want to puncture your oil pan. But you know, this is, I mean, any of you could off-road your Subaru. Just rip the bumper off like we did and lift it.
Yeah, it's really
but you know, he's getting to experience now. I mean, it really does just handle things so much better. I mean, in the past when we had it out in the woods stock, Nick knows you'd have to go really slow and be really mindful of things. And it's now, just, you know, now it's just,
it's
just
not much of that.
No, you plow through it.
Yeah, but I'm, like I said, I'm loving it. So yeah, that about wraps this up. And I think, you know, this series in general, except for, you know, some fun off-road and snow videos.
Oh yeah, there's more to come with adventuring the Subaru for sure.
Yeah. Oh, all right. Thank you, guys. Two guys, one car. Like, share, subscribe.
Yeah, buddy.